with defensive firearms instruction. In continuation on the series on duty belts and how to set those up, I would like to talk about handcuffs and the specifics regarding handcuffs that a lot of people may want to know before they actually start using them. The first thing I'd like to talk about is the two main types of handcuffs that you're going to come into contact with and that you should be familiar with while you're working in a security or law enforcement role. The first one that I'd like to talk about is going to be our hinged cuffs. Now, the hinge cuffs are really kind of nice for a lot of different reasons. First of all, when you apply them, it's going to restrict the individual's movement a lot more. The other thing that I've noticed with handcuffs that are hinged, it's actually easier to apply those handcuffs to non-compliant individuals. So these handcuffs specifically are ASP handcuffs, and I really like these, but we're going to talk about that here in a second. The other type of handcuffs that I want to talk about is going to be chained handcuffs. So chained handcuffs are really good for compliant individuals. The nice thing about chained handcuffs is it does have a little bit more range of motion, which is going to be more comfortable for the person that you are stabilizing. There is another type of handcuff out there called a rigid cuff, but typically that's only used for corrections and in other specific applications. In regards to handcuffs, there's a couple of manufacturers that I'd like to refer to. The first one's going to be ASP. ASP stands for Armament Systems and Procedures, and they actually do a lot of really good training courses, and they've got a really good product line. The other company that I like is Peerless. Now, Peerless actually has some really good handcuffs. These ones right here are Peerless handcuffs. Another company that I like is Smith & Wesson, and then there's also Hyatt. Hyatt is also a really, really good brand. In regards to handcuffs, typically if I'm carrying in a duty belt, I like having two sets of handcuffs. I like having a set of chained and I like having a set of hinged handcuffs. The benefit of having both those handcuffs is it gives you the versatility of applying those handcuffs to stabilized suspects or non-compliant suspects. In regards to the handcuff placement, generally speaking, I will carry my hinged handcuffs on the outside of my handcuff pouch, and I will carry my chained set of handcuffs behind my hinge set. The reason why is because it's going to be easier for me to get the hinged handcuffs out first, and chances are if I'm wrestling around with somebody on the ground, I'm going to want to use my hinged set of handcuffs because it's going to be a little easier for me to apply them. The next thing I'd like to talk about is handcuff keys. Now, a general rule of thumb is that you always want to have at least two sets of handcuff keys on your person while you're working. I usually like to have a smaller handcuff key on my primary keychain, the one that I use for my personal vehicle, and then I also have a separate handcuff key that's a little bit longer that I would have on my person while I'm actually working. Typically, these handcuff keys are going to be easier to use to double lock, to size, and also it's going to be easier for you to have them on your person and retain them. Generally speaking, when you purchase a set of handcuffs, it will come with two separate smaller handcuff keys. You know, definitely have one as a backup. You know, I generally have always kept one in my duty bag. And then the longer ones, you know, you can purchase them on the web. ASP makes some really good ones, but Galls makes some good ones. And there's a lot of other manufacturers that make really, really nice ones. And they typically have a little pocket clip, so you can clip it in a pocket or, you know, stick it inside a, you know, bag of some sort. Now, as far as keys are concerned, some of the things to consider are the back end of the key right here is going to look like a little cylinder. You're always going to want to size and double lock the handcuffs. Now, what that means is we want to restrict the movement forward or back for the handcuffs while the person is in handcuffs. How we're going to do that after we have sized and we make sure that the handcuffs are appropriately applied is we're going to take that back section, we're going to stick it in right here, and we're still going to lock it over until we get an audible click. And then we're going to double check by seeing if there's any movement that can be made with the handcuffs. Other handcuffs, like the Peerless set, what they will actually have on the side right here is they'll have a little button that you simply just go ahead and push in with the back of that handcuff key. Now, to unlock the handcuffs, typically what you're going to do is you're going to go ahead and take the handcuffs, you're going to take the handcuff key, and you rotate one way to unlock, and then you rotate the other way to actually disengage the handcuffs, and then you can open up
Excuse me, you can open them up.
Now, the next thing I'd like to talk about is how we actually carry our handcuffs inside of our handcuff pouch. One of the things I really like doing is setting up my handcuffs to where I can bring this bow of the handcuffs in, so it's only held on by about two of the little teeth on the inside, two, three. What this is gonna do is it's gonna make it a lot easier for me to apply my handcuffs with that rock and lock motion, because there's not a lot of pressure holding the handcuff bow in place. The other thing that I really kind of emphasize when we're talking about handcuffs is on some of the other types of handcuffs, like these Peerless, we only have the cuff key holes on one side. Generally speaking, you're going to want to have the cuff key holes facing up towards the sky, which is going to make it a little bit easier for you to size, double lock, and remove the handcuffs once the suspect has been stabilized. Also, in regards to placement on the person, I highly recommend that when you are carrying your handcuffs, I recommend that you carry those handcuffs towards the front of your body. The reason why I'm saying that is because if you are in a physical altercation, you don't necessarily know what arm you're going to use to pin the suspect down. So you want to make sure that the handcuffs are accessible by both your right and your left hand. We typically see individuals carry handcuffs on the back end of their duty belt. I try to steer my students away from doing that simply because if you are driving in a vehicle for extended periods of time, then the handcuffs are actually going to be very uncomfortable on your person. And beyond that, you lose the opportunity to retain control. If you're wrestling around with somebody, there is a possibility that somebody could walk up behind you and grab your handcuffs. Also, if you pin somebody with one arm, you may not necessarily have the range of motion to access those handcuffs that are on your back. So definitely carry them more towards the front of your duty belt, and that's going to give you the greatest ability to retain them or to use them or draw them when you're ready to use them. Now, regarding handcuff pouches themselves, there's a couple of different types of handcuff pouches. We have single handcuff pouches and we have double handcuff pouches. I highly recommend that if you are carrying your handcuffs that you use a double cuff pouch, like I said before. And then we also need to look at the retention strap. So when we're talking about the actual handcuffs, there are two types of closures. There is a Velcro closure and then there is a snap closure. Now, me personally, I try to steer away from the Velcro simply because in my experience, when I'm wrestling around on the ground with somebody, there is a possibility that this is more easily going to be able to be opened up, thus far creating the opportunity for me to lose my handcuffs. The snap seems to hold a little bit more secure. The other thing to look at is there are some handcuffs like these ASP handcuffs that are a little bit larger to accommodate for people who have bigger wrists. With these specific type of handcuffs, ASP, or Armorant Systems and Procedures, has a proprietary cuff case that you would need to use when you were using ASP handcuffs. The rest of the handcuff pouches will fit standard handcuffs. You know, one of my absolute favorite manufacturers for handcuff pouches is Bianchi. They make a really good line of AccuMold pouches, and it's really kind of nice having the AccuMold because it's easier to maintain. Another consideration is that you retain the information on your handcuffs, such as the serial number, the make, and the model, in your notebook on your person. The reason I say that is if for some reason you handcuff somebody and the police officer that's coming to take custody of the person that you have made a valid citizen's arrest on decides to take your handcuffs, you at that point could ask for something called a property evidence receipt, starting a chain of custody to ensure that you get your handcuffs back. One of the things that we really want to stress is the importance of training. A couple of reasons why we want to stress the importance of training is that in the event of a lawsuit, if you are trained and certified through a program and are following that curriculum, in the event of a lawsuit, the proprietor of that curriculum will defend their curriculum. And in essence, they will be protecting you. Having said that, at Defensive Firearms Instruction, we currently are teaching the Armament Systems and Procedures course. So if you have any questions or are interested in training, feel free to contact us directly or visit us on the web at defensivefirearmsinstruction.org, and we'd love to see you in one of our classes.